Good morning, guys. Welcome back to the vlog. It's about 4:30 a.m. and today we are going to Africa.
I wanted to make sure I packed light so I wouldn't tire myself out on the big trip. We were headed to a new continent, so I had to make sure Natalie was on her toes.
Bro, how you fall for this shit?
Because it's 4 o'clock in the morning.
Jonah and Susie showed up, looking oddly familiar.
Y'all bringing your siblings? You're dressed fucking identical.
Fuck out of here!
Quick little pro tip at airports. Always pack a garbage bag full of comforters and pillows. That way, it's like you never even left home. After a quick 15-hour flight, we were greeted by some local South Africans.
Hi!
About 5 minutes later, our Uber driver got the party started. He told us that at night, cars don't stop at red lights because it's not safe.
No one is stopping! Are you kidding me?
But I'll tell you what really wasn't safe. My sobriety. This place was nuts.
What's happening with you, brother? Yo, damn!
What's wrong?
What have you done to me today now?
The next day, we flew deeper into the safari.
We just landed, and there's a bunch of monkeys.
We were 30 minutes into our safari trip, and Jonah was already confronted with his biggest fear. We made sure to keep the grasshopper around in case Jonah got lonely.
No, yeah, I swear to my mother, I'm gonna punch you in the face. I swear to God.
You're gonna punch me in the face?
I swear to fucking God. Go ahead, bro. No, don't fuck around, dog. I'm not, bro, this is fight or flight, dog. I will fuck you up. Hey, like, there's a lion behind me, isn't there?
Guys, look how pretty this waterfall is. Well, right there, that's your girl, Natalie. Oh my God.
A rhino. Dude, imagine if he starts charging us.
Oh, he's looking right at us.
Dude, close the fucking door.
Close the fucking door. Dude, I'm dead ass. Close the door.
Close the door.
Bye, rhino.
Later that day, we visited a village to surprise some kids with soccer balls. I don't know if it was Natalie's soccer skills or her funny looking face, but the village really seemed to like her. So much so that the chief of the village even gave her his headpiece.
Natalie!
Why don't I get one?
I saw you fall, you were just trying.
No, I didn't. I never. Because your players kicked me.
No.
Your townspeople kicked me to the ground.
Fall with the ball?
I did not fall with the ball.
No, you just have the googly eyes for her.
Of course.
Natalie being crowned as the queen really helped us out on some local discounts.
Look at Natalie, they're all like.
She's the queen.
I didn't know what to expect when it came to Africa's hotel accommodations, but I for sure was not expecting this. This place was out of a movie. They had everything you could possibly imagine, from beautifully set breakfasts, wine rooms, gyms, massages, and even an automated mosquito net that wraps around your bed.
This is ridiculous.
Dude, this is fucking nuts.
Bro, Jim!
Are you kidding right now?
It's the same.
David, we cannot leave. No. Hold on a second.
Do we have any budget left for the rest of the episodes?
Dude, no.
Just make that post, bro. Hashtag wherever the fuck they want. Okay? Keep it going.
This is the whole budget of the show. You guys blew the season. This is the fucking whole season, bro.
At the end of the day, though, we were looking for something a little more traditional. So we headed on over to a more into the wild experience.
Wow.
Which we would soon very much regret.
How is this even fucking possible, bro? There's really lions, like, probably right there.
I decided to get my own room and leave Ilya to fend for himself.
What's wrong? Why'd you come over here?
Why would I repeat your fucking ass? You're leaving me, pussy.
You
can't. You're scared of the hyenas.
I literally don't give a fuck anymore. Eat me.
Bro, where is Natalie?
I don't know. Give me the fuck out of here.
Bro, hold your flat. Oh, shit. The whistle went off. Are you blowing the emergency whistle?
I don't know where my whistle is.
Are you taking your suitcase out?
Yeah, bro, this ain't no joke. I'm out.
Ma'am, we need to go help. We need to go help our other friends. They're in family room one.
And there's a line right there.
Oh, right there.
Yo, that's a fucking hyena.
Yeah, I fucking see it, bro. It's fucking 10 feet away from us, my G.
Chill.
No, you chill, bro. I want to suck your dick.
What?
What?
What did you just say? How do you do this?
John!
John, get the lion.
John, get the lion. How do you do this?
What?
How do you live around all these lions?
I'm used to this place, so I know there's no harm here.
So many brothers everywhere. They're everywhere, bro.
Because you have a light on your forehead.
That's our friends calling for an emergency. What's going on? What's going on?
I have no idea how many bugs are in that.
There's so many cockroaches under every fucking pillow.
What? Bro, I'm losing it, bro.
No, our room is way worse.
Worse?
We have fucking like live animals in our fucking room.
Bro, come right this way. Show you that.
Oh, what? Oh shit! What? That's a big bitch, bro.
Is any stop? Stop! Stop!
David, flying cockroach.
Look at this pillow, bro. You expect us to sleep on this?
Oh, those are tiny little bugs. That is pretty crazy.
Look at all of them.
David, bro, look at them.
Guys, this is part of it.
No, I don't want to be part of it.
Yeah, I was so terrified in my room, I couldn't even say I was like this.
Look at Natalie right now, bro. Look at Natalie.
Please help me.
All in all, Africa is a place I'll never forget. The most beautiful and challenging place I've ever come across.
I can't do this. 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 I can't do this.
3, 2, 1.
Africa goes hard.